Just slow it down. What's better than a video on font pairings? Well, of course, two videos on font pairing. If you haven't seen my first video on some great font combinations, you might want to check that out as well as this one. This video is being brought to us and sponsored by my good friends over at Squarespace.com. They've stepped up and agreed to be one of our monthly sponsors and help us make bigger and better videos here on this channel. So if you're in the market for a new website, go to Squarespace.com and use the code TUTVID to get a nice discount. Go ahead, show them some support for showing us support. Whether you need a domain, website, or online store, why don't you go ahead and make it with Squarespace? I will show examples of these fonts being paired together in Squarespace's style editor because, well, this video is being sponsored by them, and it will also give you an idea of what things look like behind the scenes of a Squarespace website. All of the fonts used in Squarespace are either Google Fonts or Adobe TypeKit fonts. So if you have a subscription to Adobe CC that includes TypeKit, and you can get to the Google Fonts website, all the fonts that we cover in this video will work for any website that you want, not just Squarespace sites. And here in the style editor, let's begin playing with a couple fonts. I'm going to change my header and my body font. I'm going to select this area just to localize the style editor here, and I can change my heading font right here. So our first font pairing is a font called Montserrat. I have it at a bold weight of 700, and the size is 26 pixels. Next, for the body text, I have Proxima Nova at a bit of a normal weight of 400, with a size of 14 pixels, and that gives us this font pairing you see out here. This font works well together because there's some good contrast between the header and the body text. The header is much more bold and heavy and thick and dark, and the body almost looks like it belongs to the same type family, yet it's much lighter and feels brighter due to the fact that it's a bit of a lighter color as well. Together, the contrast yet similarity helps make these fonts work together and look pretty nice. Now the second font pairing is going to be a font called DIN. So I'm going to move up, and right here we have a font called DIN Condensed. I'm going to set this to the size of 45. I will leave it at a weight of 400, but I'm going to text transform it to make it uppercase only. Next, I'll go to the body text, and here I'm going to use a font called Adobe Garamond Pro, right down here. You're probably familiar with this one. And what we're going to do is set it to a size of 15 pixels. Now, this font combination works because once again we have a very strong and bold and clear header which uses not only the tall and thick font but also the fact that we made it all uppercase to emphasize this strength in the header. And then the body type is this beautiful serifed, almost book style font in that oh so perfect font, Garamond. Together, these fonts look great. Now for our third font pairing, we're going to use a font called Scheme. And if I scroll down, it's right here. We will set this to the size of 40 pixels. And by the way, you can choose any size you like. These are just sizes that I think look nice for this particular example. And we're going to leave the uppercase text transformation in place. For the body text, we're going to use a 16 pixel version of Arno Pro, which is right down here. And then we'll change the size to 16 pixels. Now this combination works great, much like the last combination did, but this has the added element of the sort of rounded edges in our sans serif header. So it's strong yet soft. And then you have the beauty of this, again, book style serif font in the Arno Pro coming in for us in the body of our text. A worthy match indeed. Taking a break, once more, I'd like to thank our sponsors over at Squarespace.com for choosing to sponsor this video. If you're in the market for a brand new website, Squarespace has got you covered. They provide the most beautiful, easy-to-use websites that you can have set up and running in no time flat. Whether it's a portfolio, a blog, a contact form, a full e-commerce store, or all of the above, you can do it quickly and easily with Squarespace. I've even built my own personal photography site using Squarespace. I've had it for years, and I love it. It's fast, easy, and a total breeze to update. Go over to squarespace.com/tutvid for your free trial, and when you're ready to launch your website, use the code TUTVID to save 10% off your first website. When you choose Squarespace, you help support the channel, and they've been super cool with me all along and support the videos I create. So, thank you, Squarespace, and thank you for probably building your next website with them. Let's change things up again. We're going to go and we're going to choose a font called Bebas right here. I'm going to make the size pretty big. Let's drag it up to about 55 pixels. You can leave text transformation on, but it really doesn't matter for this font. We're going to set the body text to a font called Laura, right here. Again, another subtle serif font that looks very nice and clean. We'll reduce the size a little bit to make it match. Something like 14 pixels will probably work nicely for us. Once more, we have a strong, bold header that almost has a very sporty feel to it, a very strong feel. And then a nice, gentle, professional, clean-looking serifed font for the body. Now we'll go for a bit of a fancier heading. So let's go and find a font called Playfair. We're going to need to move down a little bit here. And right there, Playfair Display SC. We're going to give this the size of 32 pixels. And we'll also make it a little bit bolder by giving it a weight of 700. Once more, we will keep the uppercase text transformation. And let's take a look at the body text. We're going to use nearly the same font. So we're going to go down and we will choose the regular Playfair display. We'll make it a little bit smaller, maybe like 13 pixels. And I think everything else will remain the same. Now, this font combination works because despite it being part of the same font family, the Playfair display, it still has great contrast because the header is so big and fat and strong and bold. And of course, because it's the same font family, the two fonts still feel like they fit together. So with this combination, we get this sort of elegant print feel to our website. I really kind of like it. Once more, we'll go kind of fancy with the header, and we're going to look for a font called Lust Script. We can find it right down here. Now, this type we're going to make a bit larger. We're going to push the size up to 60 pixels. You can see that having it all uppercase makes it virtually unreadable. So we're going to change text transform back to none. And then, because we have such a strong, bold, and ornate header, we're going to go ultra simple with our body text. So we'll go body text, and we're going to choose something very plain, something like Helvetica. I want my Helvetica size to be about 13, and a normal weight of around 400 is just perfect. So these fonts work together because we have this ultra ornate as well as big and bold header, and then a much smaller, simpler, geometric font like Helvetica filling in underneath what is a very complex and ornate looking header. The contrast is wonderful. Next, we'll do another double font. So here for the heading, we're going to look for a font called Merryweather. Here it is. We'll also change the size, knock this down to about 45, and I'll also set the text transform back to uppercase, and let's make this pretty bold. Let's go 900 for the weight. Now, for the body font, we're going to go find that same Merryweather right here, and I think we need to make the text even smaller. So let's knock it down to 12 pixels, and you know what? Let's give it a little letter spacing as well. Let's go 0.3 pixels, just to help push things apart a little bit. So once again, we have a font pairing where both fonts are from the same family, yet using size and weight, we really set the header off and make it big and bold and strong, and just make the body text a little more subtle. So the contrast is there, but the familiarity is there because they're both the same font. So next up for our header, we're going to use a font called Ambrose STD. We're going to make sure that this has a reasonable amount of weight, maybe not 900, maybe 600. And we do want this to retain the uppercase transformation. Let's find a good body text to match this. I think I'm going to go with a font called Allegra. which you can find right here. We'll set the size of Allegra to 14 pixels, and we'll get rid of the letter spacing. Reset that to 0. Now, this is an example of a font pairing that in my mind sounded or looked like it would be a good match. But now that I'm looking at it, the body text really needs to be a bit more simple. Well, the Allegra SC font has a sans serif, or a without serif, sort of cousin. So let's move up here to sans serif and find Allegra right there. Allegra sans. And there, at the same size, the same everything, that looks much better. Again, we have great contrast between our big bold header and just a nice simple body type that complements it in all the right ways. Now, for our ninth matchup, our ninth font combination, we're going to go a little classic here. We're going to set our header to the ultra classic font. We all know it and we all love it, Helvetica. I'm going to change the size here. I'm going to boost it to about 50 pixels. I think I'm going to leave the text transformation on uppercase, and a font weight of 700 is probably good. The bolder, the bigger, the better, in this case at least. And we're going to pair this up with its natural partner, Garamond. So we'll open this up and we'll move down and find Adobe Garamond Pro right there. And I think the same size at about 14 pixels works well for this particular web page. And here in this combination, we have that same principle of a big, straight, bold, dominant header and just this subtle, more detailed, perfectly executed body font in Garamond. They complement each other so well, and there's just the right amount of contrast between them as well. Now, last but not least, our 10th pairing is going to be fonts of the same family, but slightly different. We're going to look for a font called Droid Sans for our header, right here. We'll increase the size to about 55 pixels, leave it at a pretty bold weight of 700, and we'll also leave it with our uppercase transformation. Next, we're going to go to the body font. We're going to look for Droid, but in this case, we're going to look for the Droid Serif font. So much in the same way that Helvetica and Garamond complement each other, Droid Sans and Droid Serif will, and they're from the same family of font. So once I place that, maybe we'll make it a little bit smaller. We'll knock it down to about 13 pixels, and we'll leave the weight normal at about 400. And these fonts, once again, a big bold header, both technically the same font, but we have the sans serif version rocking the header for us, and the more detailed, sort of sophisticated version, filling out the detail in the body to give us a nice, natural look. So, without further ado, I would encourage you to go check out Google Fonts, find and download as many of these as you can, play with them in your own web design projects, or even graphic design projects if you feel so inclined. Having a list of great go-to font combinations in your head can be a very helpful starting point to get you going down the right path for finding that perfect bit of type for your project and making everything look oh so nice.